Yes, you heard right. I have made another video. Yep, it's been a while. Been pretty busy. You know, working, family, all sorts of stuff. You know, I'm sure many of you are in the same boat, but, you know, I still love X4, and I got the feeling today to do another video. I don't have too much going on in game right now. I've been actually not playing too many games at all the past month or two. But, you know, with Tides of Avarice on the way, the new DLC for X4, it looks cool, very pirate-themed. I've definitely been keeping up with all the news, and, you know, I wanted to kind of show off some of the stuff they're doing on Twitter, since people watching the videos may not be on Twitter. So, you know, there's the 24 or 25 days of Christmas kind of tradition thing. They do, it's like the Advent calendar, do something every day. So they've been releasing pictures for the new expansion every day. So we're on day 4 right now, so let's take a look at them. All right, so this is day 1. Looks like we got a station here with some new modules. They're very industrial looking. I love that. I'm a big fan of industrial looking space things. I always loved the Earth Alliance ships in Babylon 5 as opposed to the Numbari. I like industrial rather than sleek. So this looks very cool. I'm guessing it has to do with some of the new pirate factions that are going to be seen in the DLC. We don't have too much information about that yet, but, you know, this could be a habitation module we're looking at here. Possibly their storage module, definitely down there. Yeah, very nice. I like it. We've got a very reddish looking system here, especially compared to the last one. The immersive fog or whatever looks like it's turned on. The station is in a asteroid, it looks like. Now, it's unclear if we can build this or if this is like a pre-made special station. I would guess pre-made special station because of all the clipping issues, but I could be wrong. It's hard to get too much detail out of this one. A lot of rings, though, you can see in the back there. That kind of reminds me of X3, some of the stations there. The star system looks cool. I like the reddish tint and the fog. I actually had really good performance today. This is neither here nor there, but I was getting 60 frames per second plus in a lot of systems when I was playing today, even while recording. So that's pretty good. On to the next. Now, this is probably my favorite so far. So one of the new features in Tides of Avarice is being able to, deconstruct shipwrecks. And they have these tugboats that will bring them back to station for, I guess, you know, deconstruction, reverse engineering, whatever. This sure looks like something being tractor beamed back to somewhere. At least that's my take on it. I could be wrong, but I'm really looking forward to seeing how that new system works. And this is just really cool if this is one of the tugboats hauling something back to a station. I can't wait to see more about how that's all going to work. But yeah, this is my favorite one so far. And day 4, the last one we're going to cover, looks like some new station interiors. Definitely not the same things we've had. Again, more industrial, very brown and rusty, but there's a brig back there with some guy locked up. Maybe had, you know, too much of the old space weed. Who knows what? Or it could be a plot device. I'm not sure. Now, imagine if there was some sort of prisoner system where you could, like for bounty hunting and things like that. That would be interesting. But they haven't said anything about that, so that's just me kind of rambling. Okay, so that is all of the images so far. I don't know when I'll be making a video again or not, but I hope you guys are doing well and have a great holiday season. And I'll see you again sometime. Have fun.